गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर हिमांशु कांडपाल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इंग्लिश, गवर्नमेंट MS कॉलेज फॉर वुमेन, बीकानेर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ लिटरेरी टर्म, ब्लैंक वर्स। इन ऑल सस्टेन्ड स्पोकन इंग्लिश वी सेंस अ रिदम दैट इज अ रिकॉग्नाइजेबल थ्रू वेरिएबल पैटर्न इन द बीट ऑफ द स्ट्रेसेस इन द स्ट्रीम ऑफ साउंड। इफ दिस रिदम ऑफ स्ट्रेसेस is structured into a recurrence of regular, that is approximately equivalent units of pattern, we call it meter. Compositions written in meter are known as verse. In this sequence, we are going to discuss the definition of blank verse. So what is a blank verse? Blank verse is a literary device defined as unrhyming verse written in iambic pentameter. In poetry and prose, it has a consistent meter with 10 syllables in each line, that is pentameter, where unstressed syllables are followed by stressed ones, 5 of which are stressed but do not rhyme. It is also known as unrhymed iambic pentameter. Once again, I am going to explain it to you. The term blank verse is used for unrhymed verse. We should first remember that it is an unrhymed verse which consists of iambic pentameter, is that lines which consist of 10 syllables. A line which consists of 10 syllables, hence the term pentameter, 5 of which are stressed. So we are going to have a look at the features of blank verse. Blank verse poetry has no fixed number of lines. It has a conventional meter that is used for verse, drama and long narrative poems. It is often used in descriptive and reflective poems and as well as in dramatic monologues. The poems in which a single character delivers his thoughts in the forms of a speech. Blank verse can be composed in any kind of meter, such as iamb, trochee, spondee and dactylic. So what are these? Blank verse poetry, it has no fixed number of lines. We should remember that. It is a conventional meter used for verse drama and long narrative poems. It is often used in descriptive and reflective poems as well as in dramatic monologues, and it can be composed in any kind of meter such as iamb, trochee, spondee and dactylic. So what is meter? Iamb, trochee, spondee and dactylic. It is the four standard feet distinguished in English. What is this? It is the four standard feet distinguished in English are. Here I would like to tell you that a foot is a combination of strong stress and associated weak stress or stresses which make up the recurrent metric unit of a line. Iambic, if we talk about the iambic pattern, it is a light syllable followed by a stressed syllable. If we talk about trochee, it is a stressed syllable followed by a light syllable. If we talk about spondee, it is two successive syllables with approximately equal strong stresses as in each of the first 2 feet of line. Dactylic is a stressed syllable followed by 2 light syllables. Other than that, we have anapestic, that is 2 light syllables followed by a stressed syllable. Then we have pyrrhic, that is a foot composed of 2 successive syllables with approximately equal light stresses. But in blank verse, here we are concerned with iambic pattern, that is a light syllable followed by a stressed syllable or unaccented followed by an accented one. Blank verse is introduced by the nobleman and poet Henry Howard, Earl of Surrey, who pioneered English blank verse in the 1550s when he translated the second and fourth book of Virgil's The Aeneid from Latin. A few years later, Thomas Norton and Thomas Sequill produced the Tragedy of Corviduc, a play composed of very little rhyme and strong iambic pentameter. Here I've quoted few of the lines. Such causeless wrong and so unjust despite may have redress or at least the revenge. The line is written in the both the lines. It is written in blank verse and it is iambic written in iambic pentameter lines. So we can say that as blank verse was introduced by Surrey in his translations of the Aeneid, soon it became the standard meter for Elizabethan and later poetic drama. Why it is widely used by the writers? Because of its flexibility and because of its adaptive to diverse levels of discourse, it has been more frequently and variously used than any other type. The formal divisions in the blank verse poems, setting of each sustained unit of meaning, are called verse paragraphs, not stanzas. So, Milton, Shakespeare, Marlowe, John Donne, John Keats, and many other poets and dramatists have used this device in their works. Originating from the Latin and Greek sources, blank verse is widely employed as a vehicle in English dramatic poetry and prose to create specific grandeur. Blank verse has similarity to normal speech, but it is written in a variety of patterns which bring interruptions such as pauses. Therefore, the intention is to produce a formal rhythmical pattern that creates musical effect. Hence, it tends to capture the attention of the readers and the listeners, which is its primary objective. Here I am going to give you some of the examples of blank verse. Playwright Christopher Marlowe energized the form by using dialogue, enjambment. Enjambment means run-on lines and other rhetorical devices. His play, his famous play, The Tragical History of Dr. Faustus, combined colloquial speech with lyrical language, rich assonance, alliteration, and references to classical literature. Published in 1604, the play contains Marlowe's often quoted lines. Was this the face that launched a thousand ships and burned the topless towers of Ilium? Sweet Helen, make me immortal with a kiss. Her lips sucks forth my soul. See where it flies. These lines are an example of blank verse, that is unrhymed verse, consisting of iambic pentameter lines, which consist of 10 syllables, of which 5 are stressed. Another example of blank verse is John Milton, who promoted the use of blank verse for non-dramatic works. His epic poem Paradise Lost contains 10,000 lines in iambic pentameter. To preserve the rhythm, Milton shortened words, eliminating syllables. Notice the abbreviation of wandering in his description of Adam and Eve leaving the paradise. So, to fit into the blank verse, what the writers used to do? They shorten the words and they eliminate the syllables so that the lines they are writing that could fit into blank verse. The world was all before then, where to choose their place of rest and providence their guide. They hand in hand with wandering steps and slow to Eden took their solitary way. If we are going to have a look at the line, or we can say we have a look at the first line, we can see that the line is written in iambic pentameter. We can count the syllables in the line. The line is written in 10 syllables of Hence the term given is pentameter, and iambic, it means the first syllable is unstressed and followed by a stressed one. Blank verse fell from favor after Milton died, but in the later 1700, a new generation of poet explored ways to integrate natural speech with musicality. Other masterpieces of blank verse poetry include Frost at Midnight by Samuel Taylor Coleridge, Hyperion by John Keats, and The Second Coming by William Butler Yeats. One of the professor, M.H. Abraham, writes that blank verse consists of lines of iambic pentameter, which are unrhymed, hence the term given blank. Of all verse forms, it is closest to the natural rhythms of English speech, yet the most flexible and adaptive to diverse levels of discourse. So most playwrights who use the verse form use blank verse for poetic drama. It is closest to spoken speech. William Shakespeare and other Elizabethan dramatists used it. Milton used blank verse for his epic poems, James Thomson for his descriptive and philosophic seasons, Wordsworth for his autobiographical prelude, Alfred Lord Tennyson for the narrative Idylls of the King, Robert Browning for The Ring of the Book and many dramatic monologues, and T.S. Eliot for Much of the Wasteland. A free form of blank verse is still the medium in such recent plays as by Maxwell, Anderson and T.S. Eliot. So, in simple words, we can say, what is a blank verse? It is an unrhymed verse consisting of iambic pentameter, is that lines which consist of 10 syllables, 5 of which are stressed. This is one of the simplest definition of blank verse. So we can say that of all the English verse forms, it is closest to the natural rhythms of English speech. It is used by Earl of Surrey in his translations of Book 2 and 4 in Virgil's The Aeneid. Divisions in blank verse used to set off a sustained passage that are called as verse paragraph. This is all about the literary term blank verse. Thank you.